Hi, I'm Pierre-Nov, and today we have Sonic IIM-19F, which doesn't turn on. So let's see, with the power supply set to 12.3 volts, limited to 5 amps, we are drawing something near 7 watts. And I'm not sure you can see it, but we have got the blinking polar lights, and as well as weird sound coming from the speaker, I think. So let's power that off, and get inside this thing. Screws on the back. Let's start from the bottom one. I can't see that. Sorry. Let's grab that around. This one. Okay, here we go. You can see the screws right here. I already taken one out. No, not sure if the screws here I matter or not. Let's try to open it right now. Let's use a flat screwdriver. Here we go. One doesn't really matter. Okay, disconnect the front panel. Here we go. We have to take out the LCD panel itself, I guess. Can we actually lift that up? Okay, some connectors. Ooh. Let's disconnect the panel itself. Okay. Here you have the LVDS connector. Must disconnect it first. I already see the problem, so let's disconnect the backlight so that we can put the panel aside, which is probably perfectly fine. Here we go. Yeah. Okay. So you will see in a second what I mean. It's pretty obvious what's going on here. If I can take out this connector. Okay. I think, yep, EJ connector has to come off. Don't have fire with me right now. Where can I get some? Here you go. Gonna unscrew the EJ connector. Yet not the right tool for the job, but it works. Here we go. Now we can take out the motherboard and take a look at it. So I'm not sure you're gonna be able to see this, but obviously I've got a few data capacitors. So one here, bulge, one here, at least. The other ones looks somewhat fine, but I can't guarantee they actually are. We'll try first to replace those capacitors, those four ones near the power jack. Also looks like someone worked on this before. You have got some flux residue here. This L6 was probably replaced. It's a bit crooked. As well as L12, which has some residue around it. And on this side, I think. No. Here we have some strange looking resistor. Maybe it's burnt. We'll measure that on the multimeter, as well as this cap just under L12. Yep, that's okay. Now, near the two other caps, we'll try to measure those two. And near the power jack, it doesn't look really well. Really nice, I mean. D1 looks burnt, I'm not sure, but obviously it has been replaced, as well as this R Kanshunzatsu. 120, I don't know, 26 I think. The chips right next to it is not looking fine, but well. Okay, let's measure the resistor and the capacitors, and if they are fine, we will go with replacing the electrolytic capacitors. Can't see it. Okay, here we go. Here we are in ohms mode. So 0.2 ohms. Let's measure those coils. 0 ohms, perfectly fine. This one, 0, okay. The capacitor right here is OL, that's okay. Now let's measure all the resistors just above the VGA connector. So 75 ohms, 150. It's a 0 ohm, okay. 25, 150, 100. Yeah. 0.5 kilo ohms. I think that's okay. 75. Okay, this one is in the same 150. This one in 75, and here we have some capacitor, I think. Not sure. No, another resistor, 150. That's fine, probably. Those caps, 1.5 mega. Okay, around here. This resistor, for example, 2, yep, 2 ohms right here, 2, this cap is OK. Oh, this coil is completely burnt, not sure what's going on here. Yeah, it doesn't look good at all, but I have no idea what's the actual value of this thing, so not sure what I'm gonna do. Let's measure the diode. I'm in diode mode. 1.6 and 0.17. That's a bit low, but maybe that's fine. Yep. The TVS diode is 'perfectly fine. The fuse is obviously not blown. Yeah. So from here, the damages I see are damage. Yeah, damage I see are those four caps and the coil. So first we will remove the cap, I think. Let's measure the resistance across that coil. The resistance, I mean. 0, okay. But I feel that it has, it's in short, because the isolation of the wire is burnt. And while the core is falling apart too. Not sure what happened here. Yeah. This has to be replaced. I can't leave it like that. Not sure, okay, what I can put it in there. should be only some filter for the incoming voltage, or it's a buck regulator. Let's see, what is this connected to the power jack? Doesn't look so. Oh well. Well, first we'll remove the caps. We'll check if they are values. So some Canicon 470 microfarads at 16 volts, 105 degrees Celsius. All of them, okay. Yep. Okay. Add some fresh solder. Pull that cap out. I'm thinking the other one is right here. Yep. Next to each other. Two of them. Okay, we'll clean that up later. And the last one, right next to the power jack. Okay, let's clean the solder now. And tweezers. Okay. Yeah, obviously it's not sucking the solder in since we are on some power planes. And well, my soldering iron can't heat them up. I'm not gonna cut it. Oh well. Let's try that on. Maybe not. Don't think so. Okay, let's leave it at that. Grab some other capacitors. I don't think, oh, maybe I do have, no, don't think I have the exact value. So I'm gonna take some higher value. Here we have some 1200 microfarads. Oh, here we go, 16,470, perfect. Okay, so we need 4 of them. Okay. Ah, this one works actually good. Yeah, not the same leads spacing. Oh, but that's gonna be okay. Yep. Okay. Just like that. Another one right here. Yeah, this one isn't. Yeah. The other ones aren't good. So let's add some solder on the back and insert the capacitor wheel while we are heating the pad. Here we go. Ooh, looks like complete shit. Let's try that again. Okay, that's gonna be enough. Take another one. I put some solder on the pad before. And the last one. It doesn't look perfect since the pods are not spaced enough for the leads to go in, but that's gonna be enough. Now let's see if the solder joint looks a bit better with some flux. All the solder joint. Oh, forgot to add solder to those. Oh no, they were the first one, so. Okay, should be enough. Okay, now for the coil. I don't have the exact same one, but I'm gonna find something similar. Either on a donor motherboard or something like this, or one that I actually bought for some other project. So I'm gonna be right back with another coil. Okay, so I've got some CPU VRM coils. Not sure if I should take the smaller one, maybe the RAM. Oh, yeah, not sure. Which ones look the more? Maybe this one? I can see that. Let's count. 1, 2. Oh shit, it's one double wire, so it's gonna be 4 less turns than this one. So grab the CPU, I think, CPU VRM, or this one maybe. I'm gonna grab this one. RAM, I think. Yep. This board is completely destroyed. First, remove the old coil. Shit, fell on me. Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna see that, but really looks bad. On this coil, we have got. Okay, we have got. What the fuck is this? Okay, so it's going like that. Yeah. So one turn, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 turns on the coil, and then on the other one we have got, yeah, not sure if I will be able to count that. Oof. Let's not bother with that and just replace it, huh? If I can remove it from the board, they are really, really tough to remove. Sometimes you only can get them with hot air. So maybe that's what I'm gonna do. Yeah. Doesn't hit the pod at all. So turn on the hot air. clean. Salt, too. I'm not gonna be able to put the lids inside the holes, so I'm gonna solder it on the surface, which doesn't look good at all, so I'm gonna clean that off with acetone paste. Okay, that's a bit better, doesn't look really nice, but yeah, that should be okay. I hope I didn't destroy the capacitor. Something looks funny right under here. What is this? Sure, looks like a trace. I hope I didn't trip a trace. Not sure. Okay, so add some solder to the pads. Add some flux since it's a bit corroded. Scrape to get rid of the corrosion and flow the solder on the anterior pad. Okay, let's do the same to the other one. No, try to solder that coil, and it's gonna be easy. My soldering iron isn't powerful enough for this, and I don't have the right tip. So let's hope that it goes well. Sounds as I like it's actually working. Oh fuck. Cold solder join, but let's heat and solder the other pad. and go back on that one later. Yeah, this side is a bit harder to heat up. Add some flux and try that again. If it doesn't work, well, I'm gonna leave it at that and we'll have some cold solder join. I think that's enough to make contact. Not perfect contact, but even if this thing is consuming 4 amps when powered on, it's not as much power as a CPU, for example, so that's gonna be fine. Still ends up in a cold solder join. Let's add some solder again. Not gonna work if I move the coil while oh, it wasn't placed properly. No, it is. Yep, cold solder joint too. Oh well. Let's try that monitor again. Let's just look for a short on the capacitors. Not sure if they are okay. Continuity. Okay. 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 And that's okay for the coil. That's okay too. So should be working. We'll see, since that was a lot of damage on the coil. I hope that nothing else got burnt. But we'll see. Got some flux under there, so it protects that. Let's just put one screw. I'm gonna have to clean up the board if it works. That right. Maybe. LCD panel. Connect back the backlight. Must be the other way around. Yep. Okay. Let's try without the front panel still. That way we will see easily what's going on now. Okay, plug in the power jack, which we have got right here. Turn the power supply. Two amps. Green light, nothing on the screen. Okay, now it's in sleeping mode. I think I'm gonna have to connect some VGA to this thing. Let's see, do we have the VGA cable somewhere? Oh, yeah, right here. VGA. Turn it on again. I think I can grab some signal right here. Not sure if it's gonna work, but we'll see. Okay, it's on, but I see nothing on the screen. Not sure. No. We have backlights. Okay, backlight working, but nothing on the screen. So maybe I did put the LVDS cable. Not like it should go. Yeah, nothing. No menu, nothing. Okay, turn that off. Try that again. Yeah, turn on the light first. Oh. Okay, got disconnected from the panel. I didn't see that at all. Okay, plug back in and try again. Okay, it's working. I've got some picture. Okay, wasn't a good idea. We have got some picture, but it's not aligned, so plug in the front panel. Okay. And auto adjust, I think we have something in the settings. Let's reset. Yes. Reset. And now auto adjust. Auto adjust right here. Yes. And it's not auto adjusting properly, so maybe I didn't. Oh, no, no, it's in the right. Or is it my HDMI thingy? Maybe we'll try that soon. Shit, I don't have anything with VGA right here. Let me grab another computer. Oh shit, this one doesn't have VGA either. Oh, I'm still gonna try it with another HDMI to VGA converter and with another computer. I think it's gonna work anyway. Here we go, another VGA thing. VGMA to VGA. Okay, another complete garbage computer that I fixed. When I say a complete garbage, I mean HP with undersized heatsink and things like that. But it charge, obviously it isn't. It doesn't hold the charge in sleep because there was an issue on the motherboard that I fixed running a jumper wire not where it should have been, and now it's drawing power in sleep mode too. Here we go, charger. Let's plug it in. Turning on. And it has got what? Thermal shutdown occurred. Don't think so. But well. We're saying that this computer has a really really old and crappy hard drive inside it, so it's really really slow to boot, so we have got to be patient here. I'm gonna open some mail I just received. No idea what this is. Oh, some filter. Nothing interesting. Yeah. Is it booting? It is, but it's slow as hell. Not sure. Oh, here we go. Okay. Do we have a password on this? Maybe. Oh shit. Let's read that for a second. Okay. Oh no, it's booted up. So, what do you say, XRender? You say that I have connected an HDMI device. So let's enable it. Okay, it's enabled. And oh, looks okay. Let's gonna put something on the screen. Can I show you? Do I have open board view on this? Not sure I do want to show you open board view, but that's one thing. Oh, I don't have it, so let's gonna open. What do I have? I have a file browser. Firefox. Let's go with that. Oh, it's really slow. And we need updates on top of all. What do you have? Some shit, why is she? But as you can see, it's working perfectly fine. So I was saying openboardview.org, for example. Yep. Here we go. Well, so that's it. This computer display is working now perfectly fine at replacing the capacitors on the coil. Maybe I could get it to work without replacing the coil, but it was looking really, really, really bad. So I did it anyway. Also, I should have replaced the other capacitors on the board, but it's working, so don't really care. And if it dies again, I can fix it again. So that's not really my concern. Yeah, I mean, I'm not a professional. I'm not selling my services to fix computer displays that are 10 years old, so that doesn't mean much to me. If you are professional, if you are really fixing those things for money, you should replace all the capacitors on the board, clean up the mess that was done by someone else, and well, it should be okay. So, power that off. Let's put it aside. And now we have got to power off, disconnect that again. We've got to clean the board a little bit because there is flux everywhere. Okay. I'm not gonna bother disconnecting the backlight. Yeah, but disconnecting the cable before pulling on the motherboard will be a good idea. Anyway. First, the back side. Let's use some hot air. Help to remove the flux. Prepare some acetone. Yeah, that's not a good way to clean boards at all, but that's all I have, so I'm gonna leave this way. Okay, looking better. No, on this side I don't think I'm gonna be able to do much, but let's try anyway. Oh, it should be okay. Now put everything back together. I'm gonna clean the screen before. That's not the way you should do it either, but it's gonna work for me. I mean, you shouldn't do that because most of the time you will get some liquid inside the LCD panel enclosure, and that's gonna go to the circuit board and fuck up it, or the columns and wall driver and fuck it up too. Don't give a shit about this really old display, so not gonna bother with cleaning it properly, and that should do it. Okay, put the circuit board in. It back inside the display. Yeah, this connector is a bit fucked up, but well. Ah, the other one is fucked up too. I mean, for this one, maybe I can do something. Just put some Kapton tape to hold it. Let's see. Can I do something about that? Okay. Okay, I don't have anything attached to it, but you can see that it works. So, well, that's it. Oh, yeah, another thing. This computer display will not work with less than 4 amps. It will try to turn on and turn off right after that. You need 4 amps. 12 volts power supply for this thing. I've got the exact same computer display right here. You can see it. Let's see if I do that. See in this one, this thing. No, you can't. Oh shit. Oh, here we go. This one. This one is the exact same computer display, but the issue wasn't the same. Capacitor coil was perfectly fine, but the TV-size diode was dead, so it was an easy fix too. But not the same issue, so I don't know what happened to the computer displays, but obviously someone didn't take care of them. I think they tried to put something like 19 volts through it, which would explain the bulge capacitors, the shorted TVS diode. Not sure about the coil, but maybe, I don't know, not know. So that's it, and I hope you learned something, even if, well, that's 1 hour and a quarter video just for replacing 4 capacitors on 1 coil. You should be able to do that much quicker, and also, well, video quality, audio quality, and my quality is still shit, but well, maybe that will improve in the future. By the way, right now you saw a computer display, but I will try to show you some things you can't see on YouTube, like desktop motherboard fixings. I mainly... Oh. That's falling off. Oh. You can see my face. Maybe. Mainly... What yeah, I was talking about the desktop computer motherboards. I mainly worked on Core 2 Duo motherboards. I fixed also a Core i3 first generation just yesterday, which was a dead PCH, so I replaced the PCH and it's working again. Well, and for the Core 2 Duo there was Ethernet chips. I had 3 times dead nerve bridge bug controller, one time a dead CPU bug controller, also with shorted MOSFETs and dead capacitors, and well, that's fixed a few others, shorted MOSFETs controlling the chassis fan, and right now I have especially one which has, I think, dead south bridge, so I'm gonna order the south bridge and replace it. Since I buy most of my components off of AliExpress, that's gonna take 3 weeks to 6 weeks. So see you back then, or maybe we have some things to fix before that.